anything, if you have, you know, any queries, you must have faced one thing. Most of the people, one mistake, I was like very sure earlier also, and most of the students made was they couldn't connect with the topic, right? So let's look into it. So this was the topic, gender implications of COVID-19 pandemic on women workers in India. Okay, so this is what UPSC wants in any essay. As I discussed in our earlier session also, candidates are expected to keep closely. So this is closely. This is one keyword to the subject of the essay. Then they need to arrange their ideas, okay, in an orderly fashion and to write concisely. Okay, so most of the students were fine with this concise writing. Very few students wrote irrelevant content. So one thing was the content was relevant. Apart from a few students, the content was relevant. So the problem was in, and you know, effective expression was also quite effective. Most of the students I found a very few issues with the language, yeah, but a lot of issue with the grammar. Okay, so you need to be you know, grammatically correct. A lot of grammatical mistakes were there. A few, you know, some, the main important was, one of them was, students were writing women's. So women is in itself plural, right? So these type of mistakes should not be done. Okay, they did not got, right? And you should know that with did there should be the first form of the verb. Okay, so these type of mistakes, this should be avoided. They, because anyone who is, you know, evaluating your paper may get annoyed that you don't know the simple grammar. So try to avoid. I know everybody would be knowing this, right? Women is a plural. Everyone must be knowing this, but students are making this mistake. A lot of students, okay? So there was, the presentation was effective, definitely. Presentation was concise. There was issue with remaining closely to the topic and arranging the ideas, okay? So what are the keywords of our essay? One is gender implication. Okay. COVID-19 pandemic on women workers in India. So you need to, COVID-19, and it is not just women, it is about women workers. Okay. So one thing about essay is, it is not, you should not write it into compartments. Okay. A few essays, the issue was, first they discussed about COVID-19 and then they discussed about women workers in India, and then they tried to connect both of them. Okay, so essay should not be in different compartments. It is one topic. COVID-19 and women workers should be going side by side. Okay, I'll repeat again. Students, what they did was, they wrote about COVID-19 and its, okay, economic implications. Then they wrote about women and their economic implications in general. Okay, so there was, you know, this thing they connected first, this thing they connected second, but they did not connect this as a whole, and they wasted around 4 pages on this, right? So if you are wasting 4 pages, you can, you know, on just first on women and then on COVID-19, then that does not make sense. So what should have been done? So one particular thing I will mention here. One student, Kushagar, he wrote good essay. I guess he got 67, 68. He got the highest marks. And a few students wrote stories. Akshay Sharma wrote story, I guess, not Akshay Kaushik. Akshay Sharma wrote the stories. Kushagar and Nidhish, these 3 students wrote the stories. Okay. Story of Nidhish was good. Story of Akshay was good. Story of Kushagar was quite, you know, better than these stories, because when you start any essay with a storytelling approach, introduction, so you need to conclude your essay with reference to that story. So that means you are starting and conclude, you are completing the loop. The issue with Nitesh and Akshay's story was they did not connect it at the end. I guess Akshay was writing about someone who was working in Jammu, and Nitesh wrote about some domestic violence story. I don't exactly remember, but there was some story, yes, right? Domestic violence, right, Nitesh?
Yes, yes. Sir.
So you need to, at the end, you can write one sentence like that: we need to be making our future like that, not in this language. You can make your own language. That in the conclusion, very last line, you can, that no other, whatever name you used, XYZ, should suffer the domestic violence due to any other future upcoming pandemic or any untoward circumstances, or also in general circumstances, because we want to make any country or India great again, right? This is one thing. Anyone who tells that we want to make India great again, that doesn't mean that India is not great right now, okay? It is just, one speech that is used, very commonly used. So if you want to make India great again, right? Because what we generally, accept is that in the ancient time, India was one of the greatest countries, the golden bird, Sone ki chidiya, right? Now that we are not economically sound, or sometimes economically, okay, we are developing country, we need to go to the developed status, and we want to become the superpower, not only in economy, but also knowledge hub, because recent education policy wants India to become a knowledge superpower, right? So you can connect this, and without, the involvement of 50% of our population, that is women, we cannot be able to achieve that target. Maybe that $5 trillion economy, maybe India becoming a knowledge super hub, maybe India going to space, right? So this way you can connect, and then you can connect your starting story with your end story. Fine? So, introduction. I found a few introductions that could irrelevant, where students wrote about history of women in India. That the essay is not about women in India. Okay, one thing. Essay is about, first thing is women workers. Okay, not women per se. Second is, it has been given one context, that is COVID-19, right? One of the students wrote about World War, connected it with World War I, World War II, right? That was also a good approach, because that was one of the, kind of disaster. And COVID-19 is also one kind of disaster. So what the student wrote was that they connected World War I to that, even though men were the one who became victorious, right? But the sufferers were the women. Definitely, those who lost their husbands in war, right? Anything. So they were the sufferers. When there is a war, it is not that who loses their lives, they are the sufferers. But those who left behind, who are left behind, they are also the sufferers, right? So I like this anecdote, that this thing they used, and then they connected it with COVID-19 pandemic. Okay, that as it was a disaster, it is also a disaster. And as there were losses to women here the losses to women was even more. So this was one of the way to connect. Then general introduction was also there. That was also good. Starting with, COVID-19 and worldwide lockdown, and few things to write, 4-5 sentences. And then when everyone was affected, women were no different. Then condition of women was already not very good. If we talk about workers, women workers already not very good. Workforce participation, only 23% of women are employed. Most of them, around 80% of them, in informal sectors, unorganized sectors, right? So already not very good situation. So it hampered women even more. Okay. So this, by this you can introduce your essay. Then introduction was, after, apart from a few students who connected it with history. I guess Farhan, you connected it with history, right? Yeah, you are a history student, I guess.
Yes, sir.
Yes, you are a history student, right? So it was really not about, you know, now you got my point, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So it was not history of women. Okay. So you got it. So you do not need to, and one or two more students connected it with history. So no need to connect it with the history. Or you can write one example, Rani Lakshmibai or anyone, that they were working women, kind of they were working women, right? So you can connect with one. Too much space in that should not be wasted. So general introduction, COVID-19 pandemic, or this, introduction with a story, or someone, you know, wrote a quote. Kushagra wrote a quote. It was a good quote. Okay, so you can use that approach. One thing, then you wrote a story and then you connect it in your conclusion. Or you start directly that COVID-19 pandemic hit everyone and women were no different, specifically in a country like India or even the worldwide, where this condition of 50% of women is not good, right? One of the students connected it with Ebola pandemic of Africa. And it was good, quite a good story to write, because you know Ebola pandemic was basically in Africa and it hit the women workers in Africa. Okay, so they connected it with current Indian situation. Fine. So now we talk about the body part. So one thing everybody wrote was domestic violence, right? Good point, very good point. But most of the students could not connect it with workers. So we are talking about effect on women workers, right? So domestic violence, it was a reality. Data was, NCRB data was given, lot of calls, distress calls, a lot of things. Fine. It was a good point, very good point. But you need to connect it with workers. So how you can connect it? One thing is why domestic violence increased. Because men either were working from home or were unemployed, right? So this was the reason of domestic violence, because ghar pe zyada log rahenge, people are staying more at home, so chances to become violent increases, because working from home may be frustrating and unemployment is definitely frustrating, right? And the society we are having, male chauvinist or patriarchal society, then there may be chance of domestic violence. It is not only like you know, physical violence. There can be psychological, you know, emotional, verbal violence, or again sexual violence. Okay, so you need to connect it with the workers. How? Number one, the women workers are also working from home, right? So more time, they are more time staying with their counterparts, right? So one reason. Second reason, some of the women workers became out of work, jobless, they lost their jobs, right? So due to this, the financial burden came onto here on the male, and they again get frustrated. Okay. Third is, women were working, so they're using domestic help, right? Now, due to pandemic, domestic help was not available, right? So they are again working. They are going for their job from home, whatever. Plus, they are doing all the domestic work, right? And the husband who is free at home is demanding more, right? So again, they are facing abuse, psychological abuse. Maybe the husband is not doing it intentionally, but it is an abuse, right? There was some data also written by the students where the unpaid work for women has rose to 6 hours per day, and that is too much. They are working like 8 hours in their offices, even from working from home, and then 6 hours in their domestic works. So this again amounts to abuse. Then one more point, children, because schools were closed. Now, the word they used, students used, was care economy. Yeah, it is not counted in the GDP, but now the mother has to take care of the children also extra, because earlier they used to go for 6 to 7 hours to school. Now they're 24/7 extra care needed. Similarly, elderly, due to pandemic, there were some diseases. Doctors, they could not avail the facility of doctors again. So again, they need to take care of the elderly. So domestic violence was one thing. Then even it was intentional or intentional, it was one some kind of abuse towards the women. Okay, you need to connect it with the working women, right? Because they are already working 8 hours in their offices, and out of remaining 16 hours they are again going for 6 to 7 hours, right? Then their mental situation, okay, they could not cope up, they quit their jobs. One thing. Second thing is they could not get any medical help, okay, regarding their, you know, even psychological help they could not get. They could not talk to many people. They are not going out, they are confined in one place, they are not talking to their friends much. So getting into depression, anxiety, anything. Okay, so what this leads to, this leads to their decrease in future employability. It is not only that they quit their job during the pandemic, but future employability also it diminished because they were psychologically harassed. Intentionally or unintentionally, doesn't matter much, but one way or the other, they were psychologically harassed. Not for everyone, but a lot of people. So we connected domestic violence with a lot of things, and then psychology, and then their future. Then domestic violence also came as a sexual violence. In India, marital rape is not a rape, right? Not punishable. Again, even if it was punishable, the reporting is very less. So this leads to two things: psychological distress, psychological plus physical distress. Second thing is unwanted pregnancies. A lot of students wrote this, unwanted pregnancies, but again, very general thing. Here again, it comes about the care economy, right? A woman is out of job, she gets pregnant, right? After the pandemic is over, her chances of getting job are very less because no one, even the laws may be saying differently, but no one will be employing a woman who is already pregnant, right? A very less chance, I won't say no one. For example, someone is 3 months, 4 months, 5 months pregnant, then they know that she will be asking for a, you know, maternity leave within 2-3 months. So they won't employ. And someone with a child is 1 month or 2 months, they are also not getting any employment properly. So again, their future employability gone, almost gone. Then they're not getting proper sexual health care, okay, reproductive health care, because hospitals are overburdened with the COVID-19 patients. It's risk again to go out for checkups and anything. So again, psychological stress plus physical stress. So these things you need to write, okay? These are the things. Now if you talk about domestic violence, most of the people wrote in 2 paragraphs, right? Or someone went on writing about domestic violence only without connecting it with their employability. The question is COVID-19 and women workers, not COVID-19 and women, and not COVID-19 and workers, but COVID-19 and women workers. So it is very specific. Fine. Next thing is education. Like, it was not only women workers in India, means not current workers, also future workers, right? So education. Now just imagine one scenario where there are 2 kids in a home, middle class family, only 1 mobile phone, and there are 2 kids, 1 boy and 1 girl. Okay, generally middle class are having this type of family structure. The class will be on mobile, online class would be there, there would be 1 mobile, and as our society is patriarchal, parents would be preferring that, okay, my boy child should get the better education than the girl child. So the education of girl child, one thing. Plus fees, you know, because a lot of households went out of job. They were not having the money they need to save, but the schools, they demanded fees. So they again ignored the girl child. Happened, can happen, definitely. So her education got hampered very bad. One thing. Second is the girl child in our homes, she is expected to work with her mother. So again, she is under a bit psychological and physical stress, right? Not getting proper time for herself to groom herself for future jobs. Again, one issue. Okay. All these things, what leading to future joblessness, because their employability has reduced. Employability of the girl child will be reduced in the future because they are not getting that kind of education. Because the parents are either not having that resources, so they would be preferring their boy child, or not enough money to pay for her schooling, and again she is working. Okay, so these are few things that would be affecting the girl child. Then comes to healthcare workers. So according to some studies, around 70% of the healthcare workers, including nurses, doctors, and everyone, are women in India, specifically nurses. Almost 90% of nurses in India are women. Okay. So they are also facing a few issues because they are workers. One issue is safety, security, because lockdown was there. People were not comfortable sending their daughters, wives to work because there was safety issues. The roads were empty. One thing. Second safety issue was healthcare workers are facing, you know, you must have heard about it. Lot of doctors, nurses getting beaten at their hospitals due to, you know, when the patient may get, you know, patient may die because they cannot do everything. They are not gods. They are people, right? So violence against doctors and healthcare workers. So safety issues were there. So people were not sending, right, their daughters, wives, okay, mothers to hospitals or for jobs. Second is stress related to this job, these jobs. Some of them couldn't cope because it was very stressful. Again, they are coming home, working, going to hospitals, working a lot. So they quit their job. Again, at some places they got COVID. And you know, you may say that COVID was, you know, affected the male doctors also, male healthcare professionals also. Yeah, but in this part, 70% was female. So if three doctors got, male doctors got, or healthcare professionals got infected, then seven, if we take the ratio, then seven female healthcare workers. So the ratio is more. So they got affected with COVID-19. Even some may, you know, even succumb to that pressure or succumb to the disease. Some may survive, but their again employability got affected. So we talk about domestic violence, sexual violence, healthcare workers, education. Now we talk about technology, right? So after COVID-19, for example, we talk about teachers. Again, almost more than 50% of teachers in India are female, definitely. So they had to, you know, teach online. So in India, there is a digital divide. Digital divide, women and men. Okay. So this digital divide is hampering their, during COVID, their employability also. Because in general also, it is expected for a male to be tech savvy. I'm not biased. It is not my thinking, but it is what I know about our country. It is what I know about the patriarchal society, that male counterparts are expected to be technically more advanced. Okay. So for example, there are like 8 teachers. A school is letting, you know, 4 male, 4 female. the school is letting go of two teachers, right? So what is the possibility of letting, you know, they may be letting go the female teacher? That is higher, because obviously there is a digital divide. This is a reality, and there is also a psychology that there is a digital divide, right? So again, the women workers are going out of work due to digital divide, and that is a valid reason it happens. Then house help, you know, unorganized sector, most of the housemaids, as the name indicates, maids, right? So they are females and they are gone, their jobs are gone, you know, because one thing is lockdown, second is fear. Okay, I myself, even I paid my, you know, maid, but I didn't allow her to come. Definitely a lot of you may not have allowed their maids to come, because obviously it was a big risk, right? So house help, housemates, they lost their job. Unorganized sector. One more thing, you must have known about feminization of agriculture. One thing is that I don't have the subscription of Zoom, so it will end in 10 minutes. Please rejoin, okay? Rejoin from the with the same link when it ends, okay? So everyone must have heard about feminization of agriculture, right? What is feminization of agriculture? Due to male counterparts going to big cities for jobs, generally the workers, okay, industrial workers, laborers, okay, at the home, at rural areas, there were females who were working in fields, right? Now due to pandemic, reverse migration happened. These people who were in Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata, or any big cities, they came back. Now they are indulged in fields, agriculture fields. So again, the jobs, the agriculture labor jobs that used to go to the females, specifically in Bihar, Western Uttar Pradesh, Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, okay, they lost their job, because now the males are back. Again, you know, that very constant notion of our society, males are the breadwinners. So obviously now there are 5 jobs and 20 people, 10 male, 10 female. So no one is going to give the labor job to the females. Again, they're losing their jobs. Fine. One more point, self-help groups. To understand what they do, mainly the self-help groups are female based, women workers, grouping, working for themselves, generally achar, papad, okay, generally small food items or small art and these things. So retail markets of demand decreasing too fast, because there was no money supply, people were not having enough money. So who would be affected? Those in MSMEs for non-essential, right? Pickle and papad are not essential, right? For those who are not earning properly, they would go for, you know, flour, means roti, atta, bread, everything, but they would avoid papad and achar, okay? So their demand reduced and they again went out of the job. Getting my point, right? So these were the, you know, broad areas where you can have, you could have explored, right? Got my point? Then again, you can look into the NGOs, okay? Because one thing was that not only the domestic violence, the fear of violence against the women even outside their home increased due to lockdown, okay? Due to lockdown, the streets were empty, okay? There may be some issues with females going out, so they were not allowed by their parents, husbands, one thing, or they didn't even feel safe, so they won't be going out. Some of my students who are married also, they are also saying that, sir, meri wife ko to 3 mahine ho gaye ghar se bahar nikle, right? This is the truth, right? Again, psychological issues. So you need to talk about everything. All these things needed to be written in your paper. So most of you covered these things in one way or the other, but you did not connect them with the female workers. what about the unwanted pregnancies was written, but how it is going to affect the future job perspective, that you should have written. That is one thing where you connect with the essay. So let's talk about one thing. Okay, what is an essay? The essay is not merely a test of your factual knowledge. Okay, so all those who just wrote about women workers separately and COVID-19 separately and gave some data, that is not essay. Essay is not only presentation of your knowledge, but it tests your creativity, inventive spirit, and capacity for generation of new ideas. Okay, creativity, stories, type, how you invent, right? How you connect your point with the topic of the essay. You need to repeat the word COVID-19, gender implication. No one even wrote gender implication, the keyword of the essay, in their whole 10-12 pages essay. So that was again a very important keyword, gender implication. You should write those words from the essay itself. Okay, don't write gender inequality. Okay, the question is about gender implication, right? So use that word not only in the essay, in the answer writing also use the keywords from the essay itself as such. The choice of words and proper statement is important. Yeah. So what here it is written is proper statement is important. So what does this mean? That the people whoever made a few flow charts or diagrams, no, you need to write in proper statements, right? I don't remember the name of a student. He or she wrote the paper in 6 or 7 pages, but drew two flow charts, okay? Two flow charts like half a page each. If you expand that flow chart, right? If you would expand that flow chart, it would go for 3 to 4 paragraphs. That is two flow charts you can write in 3 pages. Right, and you can have you could have increased the volume of your essay, right? When they write that you need to write in 1000 to 1200 words, then 1000 words is the minimum part. And if you are writing the essay in 700 or 800 words, that means the examiner will know that you are out of ideas, right? And what is the demand? New ideas, generation of new ideas. If you are not able to generate ideas till 1000 words, if you are writing below this, then the examiner will have a notion that you are out of ideas. You are not creative enough, right? You are not creative enough to create as per the demand of the question. Then keep close to the subject matter. Here was main problem. Whatever you write, it must be totally relevant to the subject matter, right? Totally relevant. So the history, who wrote with the history, not relevant. Okay. The story about Mother India movie, Kushagra. That was a fine story because the movie, the premise is related to a disaster, how a woman is coping with the disaster. And then he connected at the end with Nargis. Okay. So that was a very good idea to connect. So that is kind of creativity we are looking for in the essay. Okay. So these were the points we talked about in the body part. And then one more thing was, there were a lot of government initiatives, right? But none was targeted towards the gender. They were all gender neutral, right? When we know that women workers are affected more, then they should have been gender sensitive, right? They should have been more targeted towards women, right? Definitely there were a few things like self-help group, MSME loans, moratorium and everything that was, even though it was not directly targeted toward women, but women got some benefit. But there was nothing targeted towards women. Yeah, at a later stage, there was a helpline for domestic violence. But you know that domestic violence reporting is very less in our country. And it was again regarding the violence only. Yeah, fine, that was a good step. But what about their employment? What about the women in unorganized sectors, right? A lot of students wrote about, getting food or gas, gas supply, LPG supply and anything, but it was again gender neutral. So yeah, even though it was a good step, but it was not a good step for our SA, because our SA was for women workers. So what did government do for the women workers? Nothing very specific. So you need to give the suggestions. Around 2 pages of suggestion would be good enough to conclude your answer. Even 1.5 pages. So our session is ending right now. I'll be starting again. Please rejoin as soon as possible. Okay. So, as we were talking about the conclusion part. So almost 2 pages where you can suggest some solutions. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So where we talk about some solutions, okay? Then, as I talked that there was no proper government gender neutral initiative, so some gender neutral initiatives, like, you know, tele-government. Just a second, please bear with me. I'll be back in a minute. Just a second. Okay, sorry, there was some issue. Okay. So we were talking about gender neutral schemes. Okay. What can be done? For example, Delhi government gave money to rickshaw, taxi, auto drivers, right? Just a second. So we can safely say that more than 95%, but even 99% of all these were male. Fine. What about women? Please mute yourself. Yeah. So Delhi government, okay. So most of them were male, definitely around 99%, it is safe to say, right? So what about women? So there were domestic helps. So there should be something for them also. So you can suggest, definitely. Second thing, one suggestion could be the self-help groups, as we wrote above. So these self-help groups, so government can make some initiatives to procure their products, right? Procuring their products is one of the issue, because demand was less. So government can make some initiatives, okay, to procure their products, to sell at a later stage, or at least provide them with some warehousing facilities or some working cash, either for free, some cash support or some loans, etc. Just a second, there are a few messages. Yeah, government is procuring from SHG already. Yeah, but it is not that they are procuring all the things, right? Government is procuring for like Delhi Heart. Okay, and then what is that? Khadi Gramodyog, right? Government is purchasing, definitely, but they need to step up the purchases, right? Sorry. So it's not about the purchasing that is already going on. That was good enough. But for COVID-19 pandemic, it is not good enough. It needs to be increased. Then education of a girl child, right? As we talked. So wherever there are issues, government can provide some support, okay? Fees related issues, government may take care. Then the technology related issues, like for access of mobile phones, internet, right? So again, and some of them were provided by some state governments, students were provided mobile phones or anything, but it was again not gender neutral. It was, sorry, again gender neutral. Again, if they are providing with one mobile phone to one household, then it will again go to the male side. So the deprivation of girl child has reduced due to this scheme, so giving the, you know, digital equipments, mobile phones to the households. But again, there was again a divide, patriarchal mindset. Then training. We talked about digital divide. Women were not able to learn new skills, right? Not able to learn new skills. Then government may provide training through NGOs, digital training. It is not that difficult, right? Like I learned making PPTs and teaching online. So anyone can learn. So government can take this initiative to provide, specifically this can again be gender sensitive, that is for women. They can open training centers, online training, etc., for their training in digital equipments, and then for teaching purpose, basically any other thing where technology can be used or for. Okay, then for healthcare workers, what can be done? Security, both job security and physical security. Even someone is losing their jobs or someone wants to take a break during this pandemic, then they should be allowed to take a break. Okay, and then for physical security, for everyone, definitely not only for female doctors, but yeah. Because, you know, again, our society thinks that male are strong. Even someone punches them, then they can take a punch, right? To be very honest. But if it comes with female security, then the people from their house won't be sending, right? People won't be sending their sisters, mothers, or wives, daughters to jobs, specifically if there are physical threats, right? Male would still be going. So these type of things, and then training, again, physical training to women can be provided. Okay, so this was the few things that you could have written. Few students have written these things, but the idea was that the things were not, very much in context of the question. They have written all the things, generally the ideas, but as the essay paper says, it is not only the knowledge, factual knowledge. Okay, it is the arrangement of your ideas, your creativity, your inventive spirit. Okay, so you need to write relevant to the subject. Yeah, the topics were relevant, but you need to write in connection. Okay, a few more issues I would like to talk. This was the basic structure of the essay. A few more things. Am I audible? So yeah, few more things about the basic essay structure that most of the people missed was underlining the keywords. One thing, it is very, very important, because I'm reading 10 pages, I'm reading 20 essays, okay, 200 pages. So what I need someone to show me what you want to show, right? It is me. I'm going to, help you. This the main purpose is to help you people in improving your essay. But the UPSC evaluator has no such intention, right? They would look into your essay. It is going monotonous. right? It is going, you haven't underlined, you are writing paragraphs after paragraphs and after paragraphs, right? So, you know, it's not easy to read 12 pages and then there would be two essays in UPSC. So anyone reading 25 pages per paper and then evaluating around 10 papers a day, 250 pages, he won't be, you know, reading each word, he or she. So what they want you to show them what you know. So underline what? Keywords. Data. A lot of people have given data. Yeah, that's good, right? I've also shared one PDF on the WhatsApp group also, okay? You can use that data that is not women specific. There is one paragraph on women, but it is an overall COVID-19 effect on employment. Okay, that was a good summary of 4 or 5 pages. You can read and you can use that data. Okay, so keywords you can, then data, then quotes. Okay, and yeah, someone also connected it with international, as I told you about this Ebola pandemic, right? And it was good. So wherever you are writing these types of things, you need to underline the keywords. Second thing is no points or flowcharts. Please do not do this. If you are writing one single point, elaborate it to make at least 3-2 sentences that it looks like a paragraph. It will increase the volume of your answer. It will increase the context of your answer and it will, you know, better your context. And it will improve the flow of your essay. Essay is not just, again, not just the factual ideas or things. It is also flow of your language. So write in a small paragraphs. And flowcharts, please don't do flowcharts. You are making this and writing like this, right? You wrote 6 points here. That means you could have written 6 paragraphs, right? And most of the students were out of content. The content was missing. Right. So in these, if you could have made one flowchart instead of one flowchart that is like half a page, you could have written 6 paragraphs that is around 2 pages. So work on that. Don't shy away to show your language. Okay. So this one and this one, that should be done. Okay. And again, you need to work on the flow of your language, you know. A few essays, I guess one of the students was there, and I don't remember the name. The essay was very monotonous. I would like to speak to the person personally and be messaging them. Okay. The essay was very monotonous. I got bored, you know, checking 10 pages monotonous. I got bored. There was no connect in between 2 paragraphs. One paragraph is ending and there is no connect between the two again. So you need to maintain the interest of the examiner. Whenever you are writing one paragraph, you end it like this, that okay, examiner will think something is coming in the next paragraph. You are ending the paragraph abruptly and then bringing a new paragraph. Okay? So try to, you know, I know it is not possible in every paragraph that you end it with some suspense or anything, okay? But at least you can try at a few places. That would be very impressive, okay? So this was basically all about the essay. Okay. Anything you want to ask, you can comment or unmute yourself and ask. Yeah. And two more things I would like to say, or this is not the, or, you know, essay, but this is for, you know, ease of evaluation for me. Try to add one blank page at the end. Blank page at the end of the essay. End or the top, so I can give, you know, some comprehensive comments. One thing, and whenever I post the question, you need to read it properly. Okay, read the whole question paper. That is a question paper I posted. Read the whole question paper, not the topic only. There were few instructions in the question paper. One was the time of submission. Most of the students messaged me separately, sir, when should we submit? It was clearly indicated on the top of the page. So that shows that you were lacking in that, you know, lacking of reading. You need to read it very comprehensively so you would know. It is written in the top that 8th, last date of submission is 8th June. It was written. So still a lot of students ask, a lot of students miss the deadline because they didn't read the time. okay, so read the whole comprehensively. Second thing I have clearly written in that was also attach your essay structure, right? So I would like to say this very, you know, Nikhilendra, Nidhish and Kushagra. Also a few more students definitely may have attached their, you know, this structure, but these students attached their structure and their essays were good. That means they made a structure. I have posted all the essays on the group. You can go and revisit. What does that mean? That means that they have structured it. That's why their essay was good. Okay. So you got my point. So you need to make the structure and post the structure along with the essay to me, send it to me so that I can also evaluate your structure. And if I find any issues with your structure, then also I can comment on that. Okay, I can help you improve your structure also, because as I'm saying, structure is very important part. Yeah, one student made a really very good structure. I don't remember the name. He made all the points and then he numbered them, that in which, you know, sequence, what he will be writing those points. So, yeah, Sahil, it was you. Okay. Sahil made that. And you know, it generally helps for you to organize your thoughts. So that is why I would say that you take 20 to 25 minutes in structuring your essay, because writing one essay in 45 minutes is possible. Writing one page in 4 minutes is easily doable, right? Because for a 10 marker answer, you get 7 minutes in which you have to think also and write around 1.5 pages, right? So got my point. So you need to attach that structure. Try to attach one blank page at the end, so that, you know, just scan one blank page so that I can give comments, proper comments, right? I have to find spaces at the end or at the sides. So that should not be done. And one more thing is indentation. You need to, you know, if this, like, for example, you have, this is your page, and you have made these, you know, lines. So start from here and end till here. Okay. Some students, what they did, writing like this and then starting from here, ending here. Then again, this, their indentation, this gap was there, this gap was there, this gap was there again. Then they're starting here, then ending till here. So you need to write in a proper format. Getting my point, right? You should start from this corner and end till this corner. Okay. Not like this. Yahan se likhna shuru kiya, yahan khatam kar diya, agli yahan se shuru kar di, yahan khatam kar diya. So, matlab structure jo hai na, aise pyramid sa bana diya. Someone made some pyramid, someone made some bell shape. Okay. So, agar aapne demography padha hai, to aisa. No. It should look like a proper written document. It should not be very rough document. Okay. So any question anyone is having regarding this essay, any other format, any problem, if you have, you can ask. Anything?